You know, more than 80% of women are diagnosed with fibroids by the time they're age 50. Fibroids are uterine tumors that can cause heavy bleeding and cramps, among other problems, and it's a relatively common issue for women. Dr. Sean Tassone from Tassone Gynecology is joining us this morning to talk more about this. Good morning to you, Doctor.
Morning. Thanks for having me.
You know, a lot of times the interesting thing I think about fibroids are they're not a problem until they're a problem.
They're a problem. You know, a lot of women that have them, and we say about 80% of women do have them, and most of the time they're not an issue, but when they get to be the problem is when they cause heavy bleeding or pelvic pain, pelvic pressure, back pain, and that's when you start noticing them.
Absolutely, and it's important then to kind of catch them early if you can, because
Correct.
There are a lot of treatment options, right?
Correct, and there's treatment options from doing absolutely nothing to hysterectomy, which is what a lot of women are offered, but there's so many options in between those two endpoints, and that's something that I think a lot of women don't know about.
And so let's talk about what some of those options are.
So one of the main things that women are put on birth control pills, kind of a primary thing, which doesn't actually treat the problem, it sort of covers it up for a while. Surgically, there are steps before hysterectomy. There's a new procedure out called Accessa, which is a device that goes through the belly button, and we can actually melt the fibroids with radio frequency heat and ablation, and you can do that through little tiny incisions in the belly, and you don't need the big hysterectomy procedure. Myomectomy is where you remove the actual fibroid itself and you put stitches in the uterus, which is a little bit more of a recovery process, and then above that you have the hysterectomy.
Right. And so, you know, I think for women maybe to start to notice, how can you begin to notice that you may have fibroids and you may want to get them checked out?
I think anytime you have bleeding that's more than usual for you. So if you normally were 3 to 5 days and now it's 6 days, or it's a lot heavier than it used to be, if you're noticing pressure or pain with intercourse, or you're having back pain that's not normal for you, it's so easy to go in and have somebody do an ultrasound just to look for them.
Right, and it's okay to just talk to your doctor if you think that you have
these. Of course.
And one of the things we mentioned though is generally they're not a problem until they're a problem. So
Correct.
If you have them but they're not causing any issues, you may not have to do anything, right?
Correct. Most of the time they're small enough to not be a problem, but we're here when they are.
So let's talk about, are there any things women can do if you already have them or you want to make sure you don't get them to help ensure that they kind of stay small, or prevention?
Well, that's the $25,000 question, and I would say hormones are essential. It's always good to check your hormonal balance. I think that diet is essential. Genetically, look at your family history. Do you also have other women that have these? And, you know, but then yearly, if you do think you're having problems, just ask your physician if they can do an ultrasound in the office.
Yep, just easy enough.
Correct.
All right, doctor, thank you so much for joining us this morning. We certainly appreciate it. If you guys missed any of this, we're going to upload this interview onto KBU.com after the newscast. We'll be right back.